Hey, what's going on? Back down here at the property. Update on the excavator. I spoke with the rental company. They finally did get back a hold of me Sunday. I sent them some messages through social media as well as their email. So somebody did contact me Sunday, but unfortunately they do not have a 24-hour repair service. So the best they could do is come down Monday morning. Well, got a ton of rain Monday. The creek was completely flooded. The mechanic couldn't get across the creek to fix the track. I actually ended up going back home Saturday afternoon just because there was nothing I could do without the excavator, so I didn't have any tools down here to fix it. But anyways, they got a hold of me and they're supposed to be here this morning. It's now Tuesday morning. I'm back down here. It is a muddy mess, so not looking forward to that. But we're going to try to at least get everything done here at the bottom today. Get the rest of the wood burnt, get all that stuff buried, the ashes and so forth. And then hopefully this evening, the trails are dry enough to creep up the hill and at least get the excavator up there so tomorrow morning I can start working on the top side. That's the plan, cross my fingers, but I haven't seen the mechanic show up yet and it's almost 8:30. So I'm going to give them probably till 8:45. 9 o'clock, and I'm gonna give him a call because he said it would be first thing this morning. He'd have a mechanic out here, so let's cross our fingers that is still the case and we can get this thing fixed and get it going and get some work done. So I'll holler at you guys here in a little bit. All right, well, there's the track code. It's back up and going. I got out of here about 9:30, quarter till 10. We popped the track back on, greased it, got it all nice and tight, checked the other side, it seemed good. Got it back up here to the campsite, and it is a muddy mess down here. Had a heck of a time crawling up through some of that, but I think for today, I'm going to keep this fire going, and then we've got the fire down there going, burning all this wood up. And then I think here a little later, we're going to go back down the path, cross the creek where we were working at before, and just try to move some of those tops, and then work in the food plot. I know it's going to be muddy, but it is what it is. We're going to have to try to get something done, and then hopefully by tonight or first thing in the morning, it's supposed to get cold, it'll be good enough we can try to creep up the hill and get something done up there. So hang loose, we're going to head back over to the food plot and try to get something done. Alright, so here we are. I don't know if you can see through. There's the deer feeder. Food plot's right over there. I'm basically in between the road and my food plot. And you can see there's already a few trees that we took down here. We have some tops laying here, but there's a lot more of them right up through there. We're going to take those and drag them down and try to put them up all along this whole side here to kind of seclude the road over here and the food plot that's over there across the creek. So that's what we're going to do right now for the next hour or two. Just kind of clean all this up and get that stuff stacked up as high as we can to try to seclude that food plot. So let's get busy. Right, well, there it is. You can see behind me. Let's take a closer look. All those tops are stacked up. A lot of it's probably 8-10 foot high down through there. So I think that's definitely going to help out, letting those deer feel secure. And this is on the roadside. I'm going to go over in the food plot and we're going to do the same thing. There's not as many tops on that side, but there is enough to continue where I pushed up with the dozer when I first made that food plot. So we're going to clean this up a little bit, and we're going to drive around there and start stacking logs on that side.